Good morning, everyone, and thank you for joining us this morning. The COVID-19 pandemic has created challenges for all of us, but I think especially for the frontline workers providing care to vulnerable Manitobans. This is especially true in congregate care settings, such as long-term care facilities, group homes, and our shelters. As of yesterday, 16 community living disability services agencies are experiencing active cases of the virus among participants and staff. Our homeless shelters are also experiencing staff shortages due to positive cases, and we are seeing the virus spread into our child and family services group care homes, which are critical to providing specialized services to at-risk children and youth. Our frontline workers in these sectors are heroes in our community. We need them now more than ever. That's why I'm proud to announce $35 million for the new Caregiver Wage Support Program, which will provide more than 20,000 of our frontline heroes with the support that they deserve. This new program will provide $5 per hour of wage support for frontline direct support workers making less than $25 per hour over the next 2 months in the following areas: child and family services group homes, community living disability services shift staffed group homes, emergency placement shelters in child and family services, family violence prevention shelters, homeless shelters, personal care homes, retirement residences, and supportive housing residences. Eligible workers in these sectors can apply as part of two application intakes. The first intake will happen at the beginning of December with payments made for hours worked from November 1st to December 6, 2020. The second intake will happen in mid-January with payments made for hours worked from December 7th to January 10th, 2021. In total, Manitobans working full-time in these sectors will receive $1,800 more over the next 2 months, $900 in the first intake and $900 in the second intake after taxes. On a per-hour basis, this is one of the most generous wage support programs across our country. This funding is critical to supporting our staff as COVID-19 spreads in congregate care centers. It recognizes the dedication and heroism of our frontline workers who are serving vulnerable Manitobans each and every day. Today's investment also complements the significant support our government has already provided to our frontline heroes. Last week, I was happy to announce the $10 million pandemic staffing support benefit, along with additional support within the Department of Families for the disability sector. This benefit provides eligible sectors with funding for overtime, staff replacement, and sick leave costs during these challenging times. Early in the pandemic, we also invested $120 million in the Manitoba Risk Recognition Pay Program, providing a $1,377 one-time payment to frontline workers across our province. In July, we were proud to issue these payments to nearly 80,000 Manitobans. We also continue to make significant investments in personal protective equipment. In the Department of Families alone, we have invested $3.5 million in PPE for our frontline workers, providing over 5 million masks, gowns, hand sanitizer, and other necessary PPE. While we are encouraging Manitobans to stay home to slow the spread of the virus, we also recognize that this is not an option for many of our essential frontline workers. Today's investment is just one more step towards recognizing their dedication and heroism as we fight this virus. I want to extend a very special thank you to all of our frontline workers, and thank you to all Manitobans for your efforts to slow the spread of COVID-19 in our communities. We are all in this together, and we will get through this together. Thank you. Merci.
Thank you, Minister. A reminder to our reporters on the line, you will have one preliminary and one follow-up question. Up first this morning from the Canadian Press, Kelly.
Hello, Minister. Kelly Malone with the Canadian Press. Can you give us a bit of a breakdown, a bit more thorough in regards to the COVID infections within care homes, group settings? Can you give us a little bit more detail into those numbers?
Yeah, you know what? I mean, things are changing and evolving every day, sometimes hour by hour and certainly day by day. But as of yesterday, for example, in our community living disability services agencies, there were 16 affected agencies. And so that's both staff and clients as well who have tested positive.
And what was the choice in providing 2 months? Is this to encourage people to continue coming to work in kind of the weeks ahead?
Yeah, I mean, obviously, we want to encourage people, if they're sick, stay home. I mean, that's our message, right? And so some people are getting sick and working in some of these areas. And we want to ensure that they follow the public health advice, right? But this is a short-term targeted investment in wage support for those who work in congregate care settings, where we are seeing, I mean, we know that congregate care settings, not just in Manitoba, but across the country and indeed around the world, are experiencing, you know, higher spread of the virus. And so we want to get in front of this, which is why we're announcing this today, to ensure that we have the necessary supports for workers who are working in this area. So that's what this is about today.
From CTV Winnipeg, Michael.
Hi, Minister. You touched on this in your opening statement, but I'm wondering just how many homeless shelters are actively impacted right now due to staffing issues related to COVID-19 cases?
Good question, Michael. And certainly, again, that's ever evolving in terms of the numbers within that area. We are seeing a rise, which is why we're taking a very proactive approach. Today, this is about staffing within those facilities. We want to ensure that, you know, we encourage those who aren't sick to take on some extra hours here. And so this is a $5 an hour increase for those who work those wages between these periods of time. So it's a short-term targeted investment in these areas to ensure that, you know, we have the necessary staffing support there to look after our vulnerable Manitobans.
And in relation to that, you know, speaking to people who have residents in care homes and care home workers themselves, they're saying that there just aren't enough people. So I'm wondering, how will this address that issue? Because it seems like it's just a bid or an effort to keep existing staff instead of boosting the amount of staff that is needed. So how are you going to address that overall staffing issue in terms of adding more people to the work pool to kind of take off the pressure of the existing workers?
No, I mean, certainly for right now, this is a sort of a first step towards that, and it's to ensure that those that are working within the system right now have the necessary supports that they need. You know, they're working, frankly, in settings that they never dreamed that they would have to work in the middle of a pandemic, with this kind of virus that's circulating. And so we want to ensure they have the supports that they need to work in the environments that they're in. And so that's what this is about. And we have redeployed some staff within the Department of Families. And I know that we'll continue to work along those lines to ensure that we do have the necessary supports there for the vulnerable Manitobans, whether it be in our disability group homes, or whether it be in our child and family services group homes, whether it be in personal care homes. We want to ensure that we have those necessarily frontline, you know, staff who are working directly with our clients, that we ensure that we have the necessary supports there for our clients.
From the Winnipeg Free Press, Larry.
Yes, Minister. What's your understanding of some of the wages being paid in this sector? What would be an average wage? Who are you targeting here, and what are they? What kind of wages do they earn right now?
Yeah, thanks, Larry. So this is targeted for those that earn under $25 an hour, and it goes right from basically minimum wage right up to the $25 an hour. And so this is really targeted at those lower income folks that are working as frankly as heroes within our system right now. You know, they never dreamed of working in congregate settings and in a pandemic where, you know, a virus is spreading through this. So we want to make sure that we have the necessary supports for those workers through this difficult time. So again, it's a short-term sort of targeted investment to support in wage support for those who work within these congregate settings.
Do you have any anecdotal information about how short-staffed some of these groups are?
Yeah, so certainly in our areas, what we're seeing is obviously we're seeing a spread of the virus in some of these areas. And what we want to do is ensure we're taking a proactive approach to this. So as I said earlier, we have redeployed some staff within the Department of Families to help out in the communities out there. And then also we want to provide the necessary supports for those who are working within those facilities right now. So this is really taking a proactive approach to ensure that we have the necessary supports in place so that there's people there to look after those vulnerable Manitobans when they need it.
From Global, Merrick.
Minister, just wondering why the date range specifically of November 1st to January 18th, or 10th, pardon me.
Yeah, I think it was a short-term targeted approach to target investment in the wage support for people working in these congregate settings. And, this is what was identified. We need to, look at certain things about how it's put together and the time frame and everything else. So we'll certainly start here. If you have more questions about that, I know we are having a technical group briefing for you after. If you have any more details about those kinds of questions.
Thank you.
From the Brandon Sun, Drew.
Thank you. Mr. Stefanson, I know you said that this is meant to be a short-term relief type program, but what happens after the 2 months are up? Because obviously the pandemic will still likely be ongoing then.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, what we wanted to do is create, a program here to get money out to those quickly, right? So they'll apply for this. And so we put it in place to set it up so that it works in that area. Certainly, I mean, things are changing on a day-to-day, hour-by-hour basis, and we'll continue to ensure that we have the necessary supports to look after those clients. That's really what this is all about, is those vulnerable clients working, whether it's in the disabilities community or child and family services or seniors. We need to ensure we have the necessary supports in place for those people. So that's the approach we've taken.
And just with this money, I mean, we're hearing about frontline workers getting COVID. Why not take the money and invest it in more PPE or kind of measures to stop people from actually getting the virus so they can continue working?
No, good question. In fact, we're doing both. I know in Child and Family Services, we have invested more than $3.5 million to accommodate more than 5 million pieces of PPE equipment out there within just our area. And I know certainly health and other areas have invested in those areas as well. And so I think it's really a combination of the two, and that's the approach that we're taking. It's important to have both.
From CBC Manitoba, Ian.
Good morning, Minister. What happens to those workers who are sick? Are they also eligible for this funding?
Yes, it's all those that work within the areas that I mentioned earlier. So whether you're working full-time or part-time or overtime, it covers all of those.
But if you're not, but if you're working from home, like if you have to be at home though, because are we not incentivizing people to go into work because their pay is now significantly better?
I made that clear earlier. We want to ensure that if you're sick, you stay home. And there are other programs. In fact, last week I announced the pandemic staffing support benefit, which covers off overtime staff replacement and sick leave, as well as the federal government has a program for that. So if you are at home, you apply for those programs. This is specifically for those who are working directly with our clients. Again, and in the disability sector, CFS, as well as home care.
Thank you, Minister. We have time for one or two more questions. Please proceed.
Minister, what happens if there's money left over if not all 20,000 workers apply?
Well, again, I mean, we look on this as a, you know, on a day by day week by week, and we'll see what is needed. I mean, the important thing here is that we want to ensure that that we have the staff in place to look after the vulnerable folks out there in the community, and that is our primary goal. So whatever is needed, we will make sure that happens. And so we will reassess as we always do with the needs of those vulnerable Manitobans at the forefront of our decision making.
A follow-up on Ian's question, I just want to make sure it's clear. So if you are an employee and you're working in these sectors, you're making less than $25 an hour, you are eligible for the $5. But if you're an employee in this sector and you need to be tested for COVID or you get COVID and you need to stay home, you will not be receiving this benefit.
Not this one, but you will be receiving other benefits, and you're eligible for other benefits that are already announced out there, both by the federal government as well as our government. Last week, we announced a $10 million pandemic staffing support benefit, which is for to cover overtime, staff replacement, as well as sick leave. So, we just want to make sure that people are covered. We don't want to provide incentives for people to go to work when they're sick. I mean, we are very clear about that. The public health officer has been very clear about that. If you're sick, stay home. And we have those programs in place for those individuals. And this is a program for those that are working in these congregate care settings.
Minister, I imagine you did, but just to confirm, did you work with the union groups representing these workers on this program? And if so, what has their reaction been or what has their input been?
Yeah, like certainly I know the department has been in touch. Certainly our department has been in touch with those folks out there who are impacted by this. We have heard loud and clear from Abilities Manitoba that, you know, there's you know, that these are the types of things that they're looking for. And so, we'll continue to work with our community partners across the board to ensure, again, what we want to ensure is that those that are vulnerable in our communities, there's the necessary staffing supports in place to look after those individuals.
Are you able at all to give any indication of where the staffing levels are right now? You know, are you running on 80% complements or 60%?
Yeah, I don't have the details of that, but really what we're doing here is trying to, certainly I know with the disabilities and CFS and so on, we're starting to see some spread of the virus, which we obviously know in Manitoba, in congregate settings. We're seeing that around the world, and what we're doing is trying to take a proactive approach here to ensure that we have the necessary supports in place in the way of staffing to ensure that people are there to look after those vulnerable Manitobans.
Thank you, Minister. Thank you, everyone. This concludes this morning's media briefing.
Thank you, everyone.